as good as the form of man. Man is the roof and crown of the Lord's creation. Only man sits in prayer. Only when a person dies, you find this type of gathering. If a dog were to die, you won't see all the other dogs coming there. Because man is a special being. Is the greatest of the divine creation. And when he came, he also came in this man. He manifested himself in this man. That's why it's so much. So the gift of the human birth is a special gift. It is said in another chapter, Sri Ram is speaking, and he tells the entire audience, he says, Bare Bhagama Manushatan Bhava. Out of great good deeds, you have acquired this Manushatan, this human body. Bare Bhagama Manushatan Bhava. Sur Durlab Sabagantarigava. He says, the Devgans, even they who serve in the heavens, wanted this body. Because when you go to the heaven, you only go there to reap the rewards that you got on earth. And after that, you come back down. In Hinduism, we talk about liberation. Not heaven. Heaven is not the final place. You go to heaven, according to our scriptures, to reap the rewards of all the goodness that you have done. And when that is exhausted, you come back down. So he says, even heaven is short-lived. He says, there is no form as good as the form of man. A form every living creature, moving and unmoving, most fervently desires. Everybody wants this body. But it's very difficult of attainment. He says, Narak aswal apagarda niseni. Narak means hell. Swal is heaven. He says, via this body, it's a ladder to take you either to hell or to heaven. Or to final liberation. Jnana viraga bhakti subhadeni. He says, Jnana. It is the best of the blessings of wisdom. Jnana is wisdom. Only we have the power to discriminate, to judge and to discriminate. Animals don't have the power. If they have, it's just a very limited scale. Whenever we are faced with a certain situation, we can think of ways in which to get out of it. We can manipulate the situation. Other creatures don't have that capability. Dispassion is vairag. Vairag means, or dispassion means, you are not connected to anything. You are passionless. In other words, heat, cold doesn't bother you. Hunger, bellyful, that doesn't. You are satisfied with whatever the situation is. Heat and cold. When you go to the saints and sages, where they are, they face the weather. They have the skimpiest of outfit. And they don't complain. They don't complain. They have developed themselves to that extent that the weather doesn't bother them. They in the skimpiest of clothing and they are happy and they are comfortable. They make no judgment. They don't complain. If it's raining, the weather is hot, they still don't complain. If they have eaten and they didn't eat, it's the same thing. It says, in one of the lesson I read, the second lesson I read, it said, those who could transcend the pairs of opposites, who do not complain, he says, my Lord, those persons' hearts are all cleansed to receive you. Go there and reside. This is the question he was asking, he was saying, what are the greatest, what is the most, the best form to obtain? And he's saying, why? This is best. He says, Naraka swarga pabarda niseni jnana viraga bhakti subhadeni. Bhakti is devotion. He says, via this body, you can have devotion. You can do austerities. you can perform good deeds and so on, to reap rewards. That is the beauty of this human birth. If we acquire the human birth, and we do not do that, we do not get to that status, then we have wasted this birth. The dog has done better than us. So he continues in Chopai.